Okay.
The true mission of the Humanity Front to do the same. I say yes. If you're watching this, I beg you, do not allow misplaced anger to destroy everything we have struggled to achieve.
It's over. He knows I can't come back from that.
Everybody knows, Sandoval. You can't hide from what you've done.
What I've done, Mr. Jensen. I spent years patching people back together from augmentation botch jobs and systemic organ rejection brought on by implants. And now, because of Bill's betrayal, I'll never practice medicine again.
You really want to help someone? Tell me where Sarah's scientists are.
I wish I could, Mr. Jensen. But my involvement ended right after I failed to remove their GPLs.
You failed?
Turns out, my surgical skills weren't good enough to bypass David Seraph's insurance policy. So for all I know, those little implants are broadcasting right now. On a frequency so low, your network specialist wouldn't think to look for it.
You changed the frequencies.
You have your answers, Mr. Jensen. And I've lost all of mine. The courts may think I have much to atone for, but my court will be a higher one.
What?
Medical Corporation commented on
the... How about I take that gun with me when I go?
You got everything you came for. Please, just leave.
Believe it or not, I'd rather you didn't kill yourself.
That's because you have no idea what tortures I've endured. The guilt, the shame. I was told the scientists would be used to find a peaceful solution to the augmentation crisis. Instead, I was involved in kidnapping and murder. My life ended that night. It's time for me to go.
Think about it. Are you really in such a hurry to face that higher court of yours?
At least there are no lies before God. Did you see that abominable press conference? William Taggart all but accused me of terrorism. He claimed that all the violence committed in the name of our cause was the result of my influence.
So stay alive long enough to tell him your side of the story.
He already knows it isn't true. I trusted that man. For years I gave him loyal service, and he betrayed me. He sacrificed my freedom and good name to save the reputation of his organization. It's no use fighting him. He'll just spin it again. At least if I die, he'll never be able to use me again.
Look, I understand your situation better than you think. I quit the force because I couldn't stand what the people in charge were doing to it. But they went to the press and told them I'd been the problem the whole time. Power always sacrifices its subordinates to save itself. But you have my word. You can get through this.
I appreciate your faith in me, Mr. Jensen. And remembering that others have gone through similar events can be helpful. But is it enough? It wasn't enough to be a doctor. Or to attack the infection at its source with Humanity Front. I had to try harder to help people, and I pushed too far. What else could I have done? How do people live in a world surrounded by human misery every day? Or am I the only person who feels this way?
I hear what you're saying. You care too much. I know what that's like. Too well. Because I've been there. You want to fix everything right away. You want it so much, you start trying too hard. Trust me, if you deal with the smaller, easier stuff first, the big things don't look so big.
I've heard that before. It has more meaning somehow, coming from someone like you. Some doctor. Some Catholic I turned out to be. Planning and participating in a kidnapping that resulted in the deaths of innocent bystanders. I am a mass murderer. My wife, I don't deserve her. Losing her is a just punishment. except I'm not man enough to face it.
We all have problems, Sandoval. We all have something to atone for. You, me, even Taggart. Your wife will understand that, as will the rest of your family. They'd rather see you live and atone for what you've done than watch you die in shame. Whatever lies ahead, they aren't going to let you face it alone.
I wish I had your certainty, Mr. Jensen, but you are correct. For the sake of my family, I must give this another try. Take the gun. I don't need it anymore.
Pritchard, get this. The GPLs are still transmitting. Sandoval switched them to a lower frequency.
But they could be broadcasting anywhere in the world. I don't have the type of equipment we'll need to find them.
It's our only lead, Pritchard. You have to do something.
I know. Listen, the riot's still blocking the street entrance. Head back to your apartment and Malik will fly you over. Maybe by the time you get here, I'll have figured out something.
So let me see if I got this. I walk into this room with a gun, and he picks up his gun and tries to shoot me. I walk in this room without a gun, and we have a conversation. About him not killing himself. So get that, people. You walk in that room without a gun, you need to have a conversation about suicide. And if you can talk him out of it, all you really have to do is empathize the entire time, and you get an achievement called The Last Straw. I mean, how about that?
Access granted.
I blame Bill Taggart and his crew. Stirring up all sorts of emotions. It's a shame. Looks like Detroit is burning once again.
People who say they're going to kill themselves are the ones that don't do it. They just want sympathy from everybody else. People who say they're going to kill themselves are the ones that don't do it. People who don't say it are usually the ones who do it. And if you're really going to kill yourself, you wouldn't want anybody to know. Trouble telling somebody. someone really wanted to do something like that, they got medicine and stuff in their cabinet, they just overdose on that. They got knives in their kitchen. I mean, what? It happened. It happened.
Detective work, Jensen. You ready to return to HQ?
Yeah. Let's hope Pritchard's found that frequency.
You said it.
Why did I go to my apartment to return to HQ? I can't remember why. Just around the corner. I like this game. This game is very different from other games. Because, like, in other games, you try to save someone, and still end up dying anyway, because that's how they're programmed. They're programmed to die that point in the game, but if you save someone in this game, then they're, like, it makes a huge difference throughout the game.